who are part of this evening's performance but are not performing on stage at a time, sit at the table in the back. So if you'd fill up the chairs as much as possible, we'd like to get started.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the 1993 Faith Lutheran Talent Show. Kids have worked really hard for this, and for the first act, we have the 8th grade girls doing a dance medley. So let's give it up for Black Poison! Hardstyle Henry.
In the first scene of our play, we're in the cafe.
Well, Mr. Excitement, how'd your date with Lisa go last night?
Well, it was,
no fooling, sounds like a fine evening.
What do you have, Elliot?
I'll have what he's having. I want to be as glib and articulate as he is.
One Silver Tongue special coming up.
Did you meet her old man yet?
Well, no. I met Lisa on her porch last night. We just took off.
You've had 3 dates with her now. I thought you wanted you to meet her father.
She mentioned something about that, but I'm not prepared.
What do you have to prepare for? Fathers are people, too.
Well, some of them.
I mean, suppose he asks me what I do. I'm not working.
Hey, a lot of people are in the same boat. Look at me. All I have is a part-time job.
At least you're working. I just can't decide what I want to do.
I did see an ad in Sunday's papers that sounded intriguing, though. This real estate firm's looking for a trainee.
I don't think you're the type, Henry. It's hard to sell houses when you mumble the sales pitch.
Here you go, Elliot.
Thanks, Margie. Put it on the Gabby ones tab.
Is that all right?
Can't you get him to keep his voice down?
Elliot, I'd love to try to get you to keep your voice down.
I think she's really crazy about me. Ah, there's Lisa. Go on over and talk to her about last night. Relive old memories. I'll see you later. Besides, she's in Virginia. They probably want to talk.
Right. They seldom see each other. Only about 12 hours a day. Go on over. Turn on the charm.
Knock it off, Elliot.
And get me a date with Virginia while you're at it. We'll make it a foursome. We can do something exciting, like go downtown and watch the parking meters expire.
Sure, okay, maybe later.
That's what I like, a definite maybe.
Henry really is shy, isn't he?
Yes, and he doesn't have a whole lot of confidence.
Oh, but he's such a nice guy.
I know, he's a real gentleman, Lisa.
I wish you were a little more assertive. I'd like him to meet my dad.
You know my dad.
He'd eat Henry alive. Well, there's always hope, Lisa. People do change.
I wouldn't want Henry to change too much.
Do you have an interview for that real estate job?
No, I'm mulling it over.
Henry, you don't get interviews by bowling. But I'll tell you one thing. If you go into an interview acting like Little Boy Lost, they'll blast you right out of the room.
Henry, old boy, you're lucky you bumped into me and offered to buy me a soda. I've got just the thing for you.
Read this. Professor Ramsdell's self-assertiveness course. Tired of being pushed around? Sick of being a wallflower? Want to win friends and influence people? Sure you do. Be assertive. Be strong. Be your true self. Just pick up the phone and dial SUCCESS and do it today.
And remember who started you on the road to fame and fortune.
Oh, gorgeous. Hit me again.
You really pick your victims, don't you?
She adores me. Well, what about it? I'll think about it.
That's a start.
If only Henry could be more like Elliot.
Now, wait a minute. That's going too far.
Try to hold down the applause, girls. There's enough of me for everyone.
What's the price of ham these days, anyway?
Funny.
I like a girl with wit and charm.
Oh, you do?
Yes, that's why I hang out with you, Sheila.
Now take Bart Boynton. He always gets the girls. He's no shrinking violet. He's a football, baseball, basketball, and boxing star. That may have something to do with it. And he has all those muscles. So lift some weights. Now are you going to try Professor Ramsdell or not?
I think I will.
Can I get you two anything else?
No thanks, Margie. But could you make this one to go? I may get lonely on the way home.
You're weird.
Lisa, they're getting ready to leave. Are you going to ask Henry to the party?
Not here. He gets embarrassed.
Party? Did someone mention party? I love parties ever since my sweet 16 party.
You had a sweet 16 party.
Yep, that's right. Me and 15 lovely ladies. That's 16, right?
I had to ask.
Don't get up. It keeps me humble.
Hi, Henry.
You know Silent Sam, eh?
I think he's cute.
He has the personality of a potholder.
He's thoughtful and wise.
I like Silent type.
And he's such a nice guy.
As someone once said, nice guys finish last.
In the second scene of our play, we're in Professor Ramsdell's classroom.
Well, class, you came to me a mere 3 weeks ago as meek lambs, and today you'll leave as roaring lions. You'll feel free to do whatever you feel like doing, whatever you feel is good for you. Yes, Jody?
I didn't want anything. I just wanted to raise my hand.
Wonderful. And why did you want to raise your hand?
Felt like it.
You don't know how happy that makes me feel, Jody. Carolyn, are you doing that because it makes you feel good?
Yes, it makes me feel good and powerful.
Great. You see, class, 3 weeks ago, Carolyn would have the nerve to stand up and yawn like that. But today, well, just look at her.
There's not much call in today's labor market for someone who stretches and yawns loudly.
True, Henry, but as you well know by now, that she gives free rein to her emotions. She isn't hung up, inhibited like you were yourself.
Very true, Professor. Yahoo!
When you leave here today... That's great, Henry. When you leave here today, you'll knock him dead.
You know it.
When is that job interview of yours?
I don't feel like telling you.
Great!
Quiet down, Professor.
We haven't heard much from you today, Miss Johnson.
Nothing to say.
You didn't feel like talking. Wonderful. And now, in conclusion, Miss Johnson, the class isn't over yet.
It is for me. I feel like leaving, so I'm leaving.
My star pupil. You may leave now. You're paid up. I wish you best of luck at the job interview of yours.
Don't need it, Professor. I've got it made.
You know, sometimes I wonder if I'm doing the right thing.
In the third scene of our play, we're in the cafe.
Did you get the job, Henry?
Naturally. You thought they turned me down. I'm now with the AAA Realty.
Great. Congratulations.
Sure. Sometimes someone named Susie hired me. She couldn't say no.
Say, that course did wonders for you.
It brought out the real me.
I have to call Lisa. Let's have a dime.
What?
A dime. 10 cents. Come on.
Order me a soda.
I'll have another one of these, Margie.
Right. So, where's Quentin Thoughtful?
Who?
Your buddy, Henry.
Making a phone call.
You know, he's one of the few quiet, cool, understanding men left in the world.
I guess, well, you'll see.
Can I get you anything, Sheila?
No thanks, Margie. I'm just waiting for Bart.
What can I get for you, sir?
Just coffee, please.
Did you tell her about the course, Henry?
No details. I'll give her all the facts when I pop in on tonight. She can't wait. Hi, Sheila, baby.
Sheila, baby. Henry, is that really you?
The real me. Henry just got a job today.
Wonderful. Doing what?
Sheila, you're gazing at the future top salesman for AAA Real Estate.
Real estate is a tough business.
The toughest. That's why I chose it. Of course, I'm with a fine firm. But those real estate people are a little bit on the shady side.
What do you mean?
Trickery. Deceptive advertising. I've made a study. Now, private entrance, know what that means?
No, what does it mean, Henry?
Private entrance means there's a hole in the ceiling with a rope ladder.
Oh, really?
And take indoor swimming pool. That means the cellar fills up every time it rains.
Great. You're on a roll, Henry.
If a place is near transportation, it's on a runway of a local airport.
Oh, Henry. Anything else I should be aware of, old wise one?
Well, a full basement is full, right? Full of garden hoses, cobwebs, mice, and broken toys.
I love it. You're an absolute scream, Henry.
How about Louis XIV furniture. That means on the 14th of last month, Louis Jones skipped without paying his rent, so I kept his couch.
Henry, you're an absolute scream.
Oh, he'll scream, all right. When I get through with him, what are we doing fooling around with my girl?
Can I help it if she enjoys my company?
Quiet, Henry.
Yeah, stand up if you want some enjoyment.
Stop it, Bart.
No rough stuff. You'd better leave, Bart.
I was just about to suggest that.
Is that your strong, quiet, thoughtful type? So long, Henry.
See you later, Sheila, when you're free.
I wouldn't mess with Bart. Sheila's his girl.
She likes me. What can I tell you? Well, tomorrow I'll start setting the real estate world on fire.
You sure have confidence in yourself.
Naturally.
Are you picking up the tab, Henry?
No, you pay, pal.
I think I liked him better than his plain old quiet Henry.
In the fourth scene of our act, we're in Lisa's living room.
You've really changed, Henry.
I owe it all to Professor Rosell's self-assertiveness course.
I hear you and Bart almost got into a fight today.
It was no big deal.
But he's so much bigger than you are. He could pulverize you.
But I've got to hear mental fortitude.
I hear Bart was angry because you and Sheila were having a good time together.
I was just entertaining her. Besides, Sheila needs some laughs.
And you felt obligated to supply them?
Sure, why not?
So, Henry, tell me about your new job.
It's in sales. I'm gonna knock him dead, baby.
Baby? That must be Dad. I'd like you to meet him, Henry.
Sure, bring him on in.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Lisa.
You look tired.
Not really. We're puzzled. It seems the older you get, the less you know about human nature.
Oh, why do you say that?
Susie hired a young man this morning. Said she was impressed with him. Said he seemed confident and knew a little bit about the real estate business, too.
Sounds okay to me.
Then this afternoon, I heard him putting down the whole business.
That's pretty strange.
It sure is. He's certainly not someone we want around the office. Oh, well, I think I'll put up my feet and read the paper for a spell.
Dad, would you come in and meet a friend of mine first?
Sure, honey.
Daddy, I'd like to meet Henry Mallison.
You're fired!
Dad, fired? Henry, what's this all about?
Fired from what?
Henry, where did you get your job?
AAA Real Estate.
AAA? Henry, don't you know what my father's name is? Arthur Andrew Adams. He owns AAA.
Arthur Andrew Adams. AAA.
That's right, and he overheard you making jokes today about the business.
It was at the coffee shop. I was only kidding.
You put down my whole business, young man.
Not you, sir. Not AAA. Just the phonies.
Overall, it was a put down. And you were loud and pushy. I don't want you working for me.
Henry's not like that at all, Dad. Tell him about the course, Henry.
I took a course in self-assertiveness, sir.
You must have gotten an A+.
Henry is basically very quiet, Dad. Thoughtful and sincere. It's not like him to be loud. The course made him act like a different person.
To thine own self be true.
Yes, sir, I will from now on.
Give him another chance, Dad, please.
All right, I think I understand your behavior. I think. Okay, you're rehired.
Oh, great, sir, thank you. You won't regret this.
I certainly hope not. Now, do you know the old Weatherby Mansion?
On Hillcrest Road?
Right. It's been in the market for years. Needs a lot of work. Round me up a prospective buyer and I'll give you a finder's fee. Then we'll see about getting you a real estate license. Lisa, I'll see you later.
Okay, Dad.
That was close. Your father's a nice guy, Lisa.
Yes, he is. And so are you. You'll be a good salesman, Henry. I just know it.
I hope so. Now, how do you go about getting someone interested in the handyman special?
In the final scene of our act, we're in the cafe.
What'll it be today, Henry? Any new comedy routines?
Not today. I guess I'll have a ginger ale. Has Elliot been in, by the way?
No, not yet, fortunately. One ginger ale coming up.
Well, who is it, Mr. Stand-Up Comedian?
Just call me Henry.
Okay, if you call me some night. Have you sold any property yet?
No, I haven't. I'm not actually licensed to sell yet. I'm just an assistant.
Well, maybe you could offer me some assistance. My family's thinking about buying a new house.
Oh, really?
Yeah, something farther out of town and bigger, because my grandparents may be coming to live with us.
I see.
Anyway, my folks asked me to look around. You know, my father, always on the road, he thought I might enjoy it. So, I'm in the market for a new house and would love you to help me out.
Excuse me a minute, Sheila.
You're going to buy a new house?
Shh.
It's just a scheme to get to know him better. But what about Bart?
Henry's a pleasant change.
He beats Bart by a wide margin in my book. Would you like anything, Sheila?
No, thanks, Margie.
Hello, Lisa.
Hello, Sheila.
Sheila's an interested party.
I'm sure she is. My parents are in the market for a new house, and Henry says he may have something for me.
How nice.
The Weatherby place.
Oh, yes, of course.
Is that the house on Hillcrest Road? I love it. I'm sure my folks would, too. When can you take me to see it?
Tonight's fine, I guess.
Oh, good. I'll pick you up at 8, and you can give me the grand tour.
Okay.
Most salesmen are loud and pushy, but not Henry. He's the quiet, thoughtful type. The type that sells me every time.
How about the quiet, thoughtful, toothless type? How does that grab you?
For me? Excuse me, everybody. There's a phone call for me.
Anything going on around here that I should know about?
Not really.
Lisa?
Henry's working at my father's real estate firm. He's going to be a salesman.
Right. That guy, a salesman?
Yes. And a good one. He's taking me out to the Weatherby Mansion tonight because my parents are in the market for a new house and they've asked me to look around for them.
I didn't know your parents were thinking of moving.
Well, I don't have to tell you everything, Bart.
Well, I guess not. I'll just come with you tonight.
No, Bart, you keep out of this. This is strictly business.
Then I'll fall behind you to make sure you don't make a wrong turn somewhere.
No, Bart. This is between Henry and me and my folks.
Sorry, Sheila. The Weatherby place has already been sold.
Oh, no.
Yep, someone put a deposit on it.
That's too bad. I was really looking forward to seeing it with you. Well, can you see if there's anything else available?
I'll see if I can find anything.
I'm also interested in a nice cozy hideaway from weekend getaways.
What?
From my parents.
I'll keep my eyes open.
Come on, Sheila.
If you sell her anything, you won't have to sign a contract. She'll just seal it with a kiss. Henry, I'm sorry someone beat you to the house.
Nobody beat me to it, Lisa.
I don't follow you.
Well, there was no phone call for me from the office. I saw her face when Sheila said she was going to pick me up tonight to go out to the Weatherby place. So I made up the whole story.
You did that for me?
Yes.
That was really sweet, Henry.
Besides, I don't think she was interested in buying the house anyway. And even if she was, it's no great loss. I'm sure I'll find another buyer with my new sales pitch.
Care to try a new sales pitch out on me?
Hey, that's a great idea. I mean, sure thing, Lisa baby.
Thank you.
This next song is called Largo. Stand-up comedy with Justin the Joker Charles.
Every night I just keep having that same dream, the way they just kept taunting him. Silly rabbit, tricks are for kids. Why couldn't they have just given him a bowl of cereal? Last night, I dreamt I was a muffler. I woke up exhausted. Did you guys hear about the guy who tried to swim across Lake Michigan last week? Got halfway, decided he couldn't make it, and turned back. What's this business with North and South Dakota when there's no Dakota to be North and South of? No, last week I turned an essay into my teacher. He said it was the best I've ever done, except for one thing. It's redundant, repetitive, and it said things twice. No, this is a true story, too. Not lying to any of you. There's a couple who were avid Bear fans, hadn't missed a Bear game in their whole life. But one day the husband died, and the wife, of course, accordingly went to the game because she didn't want to miss one. And one of the spectators said, "Well, where's your husband?" And she said, "Oh, he passed away about a week ago." And the spectator said, "I'm very sorry, I'm very sorry." Wife said, "Oh, that's okay, that's okay." Spectator said, "Well, why didn't you get anybody to come with you?" She said, "Oh, I would have, but they're all at his funeral." You know, this guy walked up into the pearly gates of St. Peter. St. Peter says, wait a minute, before you come through the pearly gates of St. Peter, you gotta pass a little test. How many L's are there in Here Comes the Bride? I says, huh? St. Peter says, how many L's are there in Here Comes the Bride? The guy says, none. St. Peter goes, good job, come on through, come on through. This guy comes up, St. Peter says, wait a minute, I can tell you're very anxious to come on through the pearly gates of St. Peter. But before you come through, you gotta pass a little test. How many L's are there in Here Comes the Bride? Guy goes. This guy comes up, St. Peter says, wait a minute, before you come through the pearly gates of St. Peter, you gotta pass a little test. How many L's are there in Here Comes the Bride? Guy goes. St. Peter says, you moron, how can there possibly be 18 L's and Here Comes the Bride? I said, la 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 la, la 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 la. You know, last week, I bought my mom a Mother's Day present. She said it was great Mother's Day present, but where'd you ever get the money to pay for that? I said, oh, Mom, didn't you know they pass a lot of that around in church? Yeah. You know, I don't get this. I don't get this at all. When we modern men read about cavemen banging sticks on the ground and screaming up to the heavens, we call it witchcraft. But when we modern men ourselves bang sticks against the ground and scream up to the heavens, we call it golf. Thank you.
Next we have Tap Dancing with Melissa Mitchell and Sonny Vineyard.
Thank you.
we have the 7th and 8th grade boys doing two rap numbers. One is Hip Hop Hooray, and the other is Homies.
Give it up for Naughty by Nature!
Oh, you're in my jersey. We can butcher anything they
to the game and I'm down with my homies.
Tap dancers are coming for an encore. So here again is Sunny Vineyard and Melissa Mitchell. Thank you. Next, we have the fifth graders doing a play called Allison and the Magical Street Lamp.
This is a simple story, or at least it should be. Unfortunately, life is seldom as simple as we would like it to be. This story concerns a young lady, Allison, and the day she encountered a common city street lamp. Allison is a very tidy young lady. In fact, she's so tidy she carries a dustcloth with her wherever she goes. And whenever she sees something that needs cleaning, she pulls out her dustcloth and cleans it.
Look at all those smudges on this nice street lamp. Well, I'll just have to do something about that. Oh no, not again! Stop doing that! Who said that? Oh, now you've done it. Stand back. Well, here I am. I hope you're satisfied. Are you speaking to me? Yes, you're the one who rubbed the street lamp 3 times, aren't you? Yes, it really was very dirty. I'm sorry if I disturbed you. I didn't know you were standing behind the street lamp. That's because I wasn't. Who said I was? No one. But you did step out from behind it, so that's what I assumed. You're much too assuming, young lady. That's your trouble. I wasn't behind the street lamp at all. I was inside it, and I wasn't standing, I was sleeping. I've been sleeping for the past 50 years.
50 years?
Well, almost 50. Of course, I've been awakened once or twice in those 50 years. The last time was about 2 years ago when somebody stopped to scratch his back on the street lamp. I probably would have gotten another 50 years sleep if you hadn't been such a busybody. Who told you to clean this street lamp? Why didn't you mind your own business? I'm afraid I don't understand you at all. Who are you, anyway? Do you mean to say you've never read about me?
No, I don't believe so. I've read about dragons and knights in armor and damsels in distress, and I remember reading about pirates who sailed the bounding main and cowboys who rode the open range, but I've never read about nasty young men who sleep in street lamps.
Nasty? That's a fine way to speak to someone who's about to grant you 3 wishes.
The more you speak to me, the less I understand.
Do I have to spell it out for you? I'm the genie of this lamp.
You're a genie?
My card.
Member International Brotherhood of Lamp Genies, Local 527.
That's me.
Well, this card certainly looks like a genuine, but what are you doing in a street lamp? I thought genies were only found in those funny-looking oil lamps.
Are you kidding? Do you have any idea how often household lamps are polished? Why, I'd have to wake up every... I'd have to wake up every week. Oh, come now, oil lamps indeed. They went out with open sesame. Nobody uses oil lamps anymore. I went modern days ago.
Why did you choose a street lamp? I'd think you'd choose a table lamp or a chandelier or even a flashlight.
Are you kidding? Do you have any idea how often household lamps are polished? Why, I'd have to wake up every week. Ugh, what a horrifying thought. Flashlights are out of the question, too. How could I possibly get any sleep with people constantly putting batteries in my nose?
You seem to be a very lazy genie. All you think about is sleep.
Believe me, my dear girl, once you're old as I am, you need your rest. I've been around ever since lamps were invented.
I see. You said something about three wishes.
Yes, of course. Anyone who rubs the street lamp three times gets to make three wishes. Those are the rules. Why they reward people who wake me up, I'll never know.
Three wishes, eh? I know what my first wish will be.
Make it... Wait a minute. You can't just go making wishes just like that. There are some limitations, you know. I can't accept any wish for goods or money in excess of $1,000. We operate on a budget, you see.
I see. Are there any other limitations?
Just one. Once you make a wish, you can't change your mind.
Well, that seems fair enough. Now give me some time, and I'll make my first wish.
Make it snappy. I don't have all day.
All right. Give me some time.
Speaking of time, it's almost time for my nap. Hurry up. Make your wishes.
All right. I wish you'd stop bothering me.
Granted. That's your first wish. Now make your second.
Just a minute. What do you mean that's my first wish? I didn't wish for anything.
Yes, you did. You wish that I would stop bothering you. Well, I have. You can take all the time you want to think about your two remaining wishes. I won't say a word.
You know that's not what I wanted to wish for.
Then why did you wish for it? Once you make a wish, you can't change your mind. That's the rule.
I still think you're cheating me. Genies are supposed to give away gold and jewels and things like that, not promises to remain quiet. Why, you're nothing but a great big fraud. I ought to have you arrested for impersonating a genie. I wish a police person would come here right now. No, I didn't mean that.
Your wish is granted. That's wish number two.
You cheated me again!
What's going on here? Who cheated you, young lady?
He did. He was supposed to grant me three wishes, and he tricked me into wasting two of them. Then I wished that you would come in.
Slow down a bit, young lady. Now please, start from the beginning.
It all started when I rubbed the smudges from this street lamp. It really was very dirty.
Did you clean the street lamp?
Yes.
Are you employed by the electrical company?
No, but...
Aha, tampering with city property. That's serious violation, miss. These electrical wires are very dangerous. I'll have to take you down to the station.
But you don't understand, officer. He was sleeping inside
this... Sleeping here? No loitering in city streets. I'll have to take you down to the station also.
Is that all you ever do? Take people down to the station?
I'm a policewoman. I'm supposed to maintain law and order.
Well, I wish you weren't so zealous about doing your job.
Granted.
You two look like good citizens, so forget those violations. Have a nice day.
Well, that's that. You've had your three wishes. Now I'm gonna get another 50 years sleep. Oh, and don't bother trying to rub the street lamp again. Only three wishes to a customer. Those are the rules.
Oh my, I had the chance of a lifetime and I blew it.
I hate it when they cry. Don't cry.
Oh, you're a fine one to say don't cry. You made me cry with your tricks. I thought I was gonna get all sorts of nice things for my three wishes, but instead, I got nothing.
Not quite.
What do you mean?
You're entitled to a few consolation prizes.
How nice, just like a TV game show.
Here's the first. This lollipop comes to you courtesy from Mom and Pop Benson's Candy Store, the home of tasty tidbits to tantalize your taste buds.
Gee, thanks.
And from Apollo Theater located at Main and Maple Streets, free passes to every movie for the next 3 months. How about that, everybody? Let's give Allison a big hand. And finally, from Happy Harry's Hamburger Haven and Hot Dog Heaven, a humdinger of a prize from Happy Harry himself.
Good for all the hot dogs and hamburgers your hands can handle. How, lovely?
Let's hear it once more for Allison, everybody. Well, I guess this is goodbye. Enjoy your consolation prizes.
Wait, tell me, Jeannie. Do you always give out such nice consolation prizes?
No. In fact, they never gave them out before. This was the first time.
Why?
You were crying.
And that touched a soft spot in your heart, right?
Not. If I hadn't given you something, you never would have stopped crying. And with all that noise, I never would have gotten back to sleep.
Thank you.
Girls, I know you're tired, but we have one more shoot, and then we're done.
One thing to say, you better work. One thing to say, you better work.
Get backwards in less than 15 seconds.
WVUTSRQPONMLKJIHGFEDCBA.
Space, the final frontier. The fifth grade had put together a shocking star story of Far Trek.
We are proud to present Far Trek, another incredible adventure in future time and space. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. It's a 5-year mission to win games for Faith Lutheran School. Come with us now as our intrepid Captain Jane Kor and her devoted crew, Miss Squawk and Lieutenant Futura, face the ultimate challenge in outer space, the adventure of the missing ingredient. As our story opens, we find the Enterprise orbiting the planet Crayon, waiting for orders from the fleet headquarters.
Captain Jerk! Captain Jerk! Miss Squawk, how many times do I have to tell you? My name is Quirk. Q-U-I-R-K. Quirk.
Sorry, Captain. Just trying to be logical. A message has just come for you from Fleet Headquarters.
What does it say?
I don't know. I can't read it.
Why? Is it in code?
No, the lights burned out in the communications room.
Make a note of that, Futura. Wait, I'm getting the message on my pocket receiver.
What does it say, Captain?
Dear Captain Jerk, darn it, that should be Quirk. Dr. Calvary, the mad scientist, has stolen the secret ingredient, which might mean the game for Faith Lutheran School. What's worse, he's murdered all the scientists who worked on the formula, so we can't make any more. Please go and bring the ingredient back to us. Yours truly, Fleet Headquarters. Well, crew, that's it. We've got a mission to perform. Dr. Calvary has a hideout on the planet Drano 2. Stand by to go to Galactic Overdrive for Drano 2. Here we are on Drano 2.
Boy, that was a short trip.
This is a short skit. All right, everybody, out to look for Dr. Calvary. His hideout should be around here someplace. Keep your phasers handy. You never know what that tricky little rat's going to do.
For me, eh? Little does he know that my men are hiding along the path with paralysis guns. John, in just a minute now, those far trackers will be as stiff as boards. Ah, that should do it. Bring them in, men. So what does the great Captain Jerk have to say now?
That's Quirk. You'll never get away with this, you dog.
Oh, yes, I will. Put them into the extra.